And our winner for the second night in a row, taking the win in the Rumble on the Gumbo 50 at Greenville Speedway in Greenville, Mississippi. His seventh win of the season, none other than the Chattanooga Flash, Ronnie Johnson. Ronnie, the Rumble on the Gumbo. It lived up to its name tonight.
And I'll tell you what, when we got here, first I thought we were going to get rained out. Then they got the track rolled in. The rain, actually it didn't rain here, but it was raining all around us. You could see it. You could see it storming to the south of us. And we got out there. We had a pretty good qualifying run and got locked in and started to race. And the car was too tight, and we started losing spots. We dropped back to fourth, and it started coming to me, and then all the excitement began. And it was just an action-packed night. And actually, we were just the recipient, you know, of all the attrition. And we got the win after some cars came out. And after the race was over, now that the rain's gone and the clouds have moved out, I've had a couple of people point out to me that it's a full moon. So it's definitely an action-packed night. But, you know, we're here tonight. We're getting interviewed for winning the race and may not rightfully deserve to be here. There were some faster cars. We just we were not the victim tonight. We actually got a lot of damage to the car, but was able to hold on there and get the win.
You had some new people around you at the end of the race. How about Marcus Minga up there running side by side with you?
Marcus told me last night he had a fourth place finish last night at Jackson, and I congratulated him today, and he said he was mad. He said because he ran fourth. He said, I've never been teched. He said Tim didn't tech me. So tonight he's second place, and Tim got to tech him. So I'm proud for him. Marcus is, you know, I've seen him for years. He goes, you know, nearly every race I'm at down this way, he's there, whether he's running good or running bad. You never see him mad. So, you know, it's good to see somebody like that have a good run. And, you know, and he locked in tonight. So he had a good run. You know, he and I both, you know, were given a couple of gifts. But again, you know, good to see that.
Well, whether it's a gift or whether you did what you did last night and run away from him, a win's a win.
Well, we got into, you know, there was a couple of cars had some trouble, and so we got a spot there, and we passed a car and got into second, and it looked like we were starting to make some time on Johnny. Of course, you never know. He may have just been riding or whatever. The groove changes here, and when you're the leader, it's hard to keep up with that. You know, when you're not leading, you know, you can afford to move around and try to find a line. But it looked like maybe we're going to get to race with him, and we had some ill-timed cautions there, and I'm not sure what happened on that restart there when we fired. All of a sudden, we all took off there, and I don't know if Johnny's car faltered or the third-place car got into him on the start or what, but next thing I know, we're all piled up. And, you know, I'm trying to miss that, and I guess guys were getting shoved into each other, and so that's when we got a lot of damage, and we inherited the lead there with about 15 to go.
Did the damage that you had on the 5 car, did that affect the handling of the car any? Any damage to the working parts?
The biggest thing that happened there was, and I don't know if it happened in that or in one of the earlier skirmishes on a restart, or I got into the berm up there one time on a restart, but we had a right rear tire going down. It's probably flat by now, but it was going down, and the car was real loose getting in the corner and real tight coming off. Honestly, I couldn't tell you with that if all the damage hurt me or not. Another real concern was on the restart there. I couldn't see out the left side door going down the straightaway, and I could hear a car, but I didn't know if it was inside me, behind me. When they're close enough, you can hear them. And then the last thing I wanted to do was turn down in front of somebody. I knew I needed to get to the bottom on the restart, but I didn't want to turn down in front of somebody and cause another pile up. So that was a hindrance there. But we finally got a little bit of distance there, you know, to where I could move down and run my line.
Ronnie Johnson picks up win number 7 tonight and his second of the weekend in the Rumble on the Gumbo 50 at Greenville Speedway.